Hi, it's Brian here with GoEngineer. I'd like to take a moment and talk with you about how we manage our data. I know, sounds pretty painful, right? But not as painful as if we don't talk about how we manage our data. If you'll bear with me for a few moments, we'll get to the other side of this topic with a better understanding of product data management. So we all know SolidWorks is a powerful parametric design tool that allows us to rapidly create new concepts and update our existing designs. These designs are connected to one another through a web of references that, if mismanaged, can be broken, lost, or unintentionally modified very easily. This can create hours of frustrating rework for our designers and engineers. These are the most expensive hours to a business because they're not going toward improving designs. They're spent fixing things that don't have to be broken. Reference management is one of the main reasons SolidWorks created PDM. SolidWorks Pdm is a secure vaulting system designed to manage your SolidWorks CAD data as well as non-SolidWorks files such as Word documents or Excel spreadsheets in an easy-to-use Windows Explorer-based interface. As you rename and reuse your designs, the Pdm system keeps track of changes so associated files maintain their references. As a company grows and its products mature, we ultimately end up creating multiple versions and revisions of the same parts and assemblies. No longer do we need to come up with complex naming conventions to try and keep track of everything because PDM does that for us. With PDM, we can have a production design that uses version 3 of a part, and we can have another design that uses version 7 of the same part without any issues. But what if we have multiple people working on the same project? How do we keep everybody working without overriding each other's designs? Well, with SolidWorks PDM, that's no longer an issue. When a designer begins, they have the option to either view or check out a part. They can only modify a document once they have it checked out, and only one user can have a file checked out at a time. All other users can view a read-only version of the file until it's checked back in. This allows multiple users to work on a large assembly at the same time while they have only the components they're working on checked out. So we've seen how PDM manages references, maintains a working history across designs, and enables productive collaboration between our designers. Let's take a look at how PDM helps take our designs through the approval process and into production. Workflows dictate which state a file is in, who has access to it in that state, and what they can do or not do to the file. For example, if an engineer creates a design, it most likely has to be approved by a manager. It may also need to be approved by the manufacturing group, the purchasing group, or a department director. As the file is moved from state to state, SolidWorks PDM can automatically notify the next department that there is a file ready for review. Whether approved or denied, the workflow controls who is notified next. So that's a quick rundown of the SolidWorks data management tools. If you'd like to learn more about how SolidWorks PDM can help improve your communication and help minimize your data management issues, please contact us at GoEngineer.